Hi, welcome to our Comma Topics channel. Our topic of discussion is Free Wilson approach, a part of QSAR. So it is a true structure activity relationship model. It is also called as de novo model. The biological activity of a compound is the sum of contributions of all the substituents and the parent moiety in this case. So it is based on the following assumptions. The entire drug list should have the same parent structure. The substitution pattern in various derivatives has to be same. The substitutions have to contribute to the biological activity additively. So let us take this example. It is given by an equation, substitution, contribution of the substitution and contribution of the parent structure and the average activity. So log 1 by C is represented here as the mu. So the presence of a particular substituent or the structural feature is given as 1, and the absence of a particular substituent or structural feature is represented as 0. The Free Wilson approach is based on the additive mathematical model in which a particular substituent in a specific position is assumed to make additive constant contribution to the biological activity of the molecule in a series of chemically related molecules. So this approach is Free Wilson approach. So let us take this example, a particular compound, a series of compounds. So totally there are 22 compounds. The substitutions are taken into consideration. Here it is having a good R square value of 0.94. So for every descriptor, the particular value is computed and it is fitted into an equation. So here they arrive at a conclusion like this: the biological activity increases with the lipophilicity, for example fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. You can see in this table, suppose if there is fluorine, the activity increases. If there is chlorine, the activity increases. If it is iodine, the activity increases, and biological activity increases with the electron donor capacity. Suppose a methyl group is substituted, it increases the activity. And the biological activity at the para position is greater than the meta substituent. So like this kind of a mixed approach is called Free Wilson approach. So let us see the advantages and limitations of Free Wilson approach. Free Wilson approach is a simpler and faster, cheaper method, and no substitution constants like which is required in Hann's equation are required, such as pi, sigma or ES. Efficiency of this method is high with greater complex structures. The substitution which can or cannot fulfill the principle of additivity can be recognized. Let us see the limitations. As a prediction of activity, the increments outside the substituents used in the data set by extrapolation is not possible, which is possible with the Hann's analysis. Structural variation is necessary in at least two different positions of the substitution. Every substituent occurs only once in the data set, which leads to single point determination. In most cases, a large number of parameters are needed to describe relatively a few number of compounds, sometimes leading to an equation which is not statistically significant. So these are the limitations of Free Wilson approach. Apart from this, a small number of new analogs can be predicted. Only small numbers can be predicted from this approach. So it is limited to linear additive structure activity relationships. So next is a modification of Free Wilson approach, which is a mixed approach. Fujita and Band suggested a conversion of biological activity to log 1 by C, as in case of Hann's equation, mu in the activity of the unsubstituted parent molecule instead of the average activity. Kubini has combined the Hann's and Free Wilson model as a mixed approach. So they have mixed this equation and derived a new equation. The mixed approach was developed to find the possible interactions between the physicochemical parameters of the substituents used. So this approach is a mixed approach. So the next is Craig plot. So it compares two separate physical properties of different substituents. It will appear like this. Let us take an example of sigma and Hann's constant and Hammett constant. The Craig plot is a XY axis plot. So here, let us take the methyl ketone groups have a similar cyano group and a methyl ketone group have a similar pi and sigma values, whereas cyano group and trifluoromethyl groups have different pi and sigma values. So this is the trifluoromethyl group, and this is the methyl ketone group, and this is the cyano group. So it's like a mixed approach, the cyano group. So this approach plot is useful in determining which substituents could be used in the QSAR. The next approach in QSAR is topless schemes, which is actually a decision tree model. It is a non-mathematical, non-statistical approach in QSAR, useful in planning the synthesis of analogs, a series of analogs. So here you will have three things. When you add a substituent, whether the activity is equal, low or decreasing, or whether it is increasing. So here it is applicable for aromatic substitutions. Let us take a 4-chloro analog. Suppose when you add chlorine, when the activity increases, suppose when one more chlorine will be added. Suppose the activity decreases, it is removed, substituted with O-methyl substitution. Suppose the activity is less, metachloro substitution is also tried. So it is like applying a thing and checking it, and it goes like a tree model. So this is a topless decision tree model. So these are the some of the approaches in QSAR. I hope it will be useful for you. Thank you for listening. Happy learning. Kindly share this to more of your friends. If you like this video, kindly press the like button. Kindly subscribe to our Pharma Topics channel for further updates. Thank you.